Hello and greetings from Iceland. Today's topic is the third glacier flood since late July, and it comes from under Mýrdalskökull glacier, the huge ice cap that covers one of Iceland's largest caldera, Katla, with up to 700 meters thick ice. And floods from there are quite normal up to a certain point, but the flood in July, it was not normal. It removed a part of Iceland's highway number one, and we were in fact lucky not to lose this bridge as well, but the road had already been fixed when I drove by just a few weeks ago. But the blowing sand describes how the flood removed a part of the little vegetation that is to be found there near the glacier. It's not the best place to be planting trees here in Iceland. And after the big flood in July, we got another one in August. And it was highly unusual to get floods with such a short interval. And then we got the third one just days ago. It was also small, not enough to cause any damage, but enough to put all systems on high alert. So what is going on under the glacier in the volcano Katla? And what we know to be obvious is that it takes heat to melt the ice, but the rest of the story is almost as well hidden as the volcano itself. But every large flood, it changes the landscape under there, of course. So small floods might just be a part of the future, which is actually good news for our roads and bridges. But I have another question, and it is more serious, or are we seeing Katla getting ready for the first eruption since 1918? But this enormous volcano is long overdue, and believe me, eruptions there, they are nothing like the Reykjanes Peninsula. In fact, if I take Katla on your topography map and place it here on the peninsula by Reykjavík, it is easy to see that this volcano alone is larger than the capital region. And despite the fact that we have been quite proud of our security system around Katla in order to keep our tourists safe, we have found out through the first flood that it is not as good as it should be. And I'm hoping that it will get fixed soon. This has to do with our communication network. We have this large area that needs to be evacuated instantly, and at any given time there are thousands of tourists around. And if earthquakes would take out parts of the mobile network, it could get impossible to get SMS warnings to tourists, which could end up with a major disaster. In addition to everything else, we know for a fact that a Katla eruption would turn a day into a night. As for the ash fall alone, and the lightnings that follow, they can be fatal. But worst of all, there will be enormous floods that follow, that wipe everything out. And history is written all over the ground around here. And even a whole town might be in the flood's path, although it's unlikely, since Katla has several old flood paths. But the outcome depends on where the fire comes up exactly. In this enormous caldera, that is 10 times the size of Eyjafjallajökull that erupted in 2010. And now is the time of year when a glacier is lighter due to the summer melting. It's also the time of year when we see increased unrest. And that unrest is normal up to a certain limit. But we have already gone beyond that with the first flood. And if we add how the earthquakes have been developing into this equation, our experts have been saying recently that Katla looks suspicious, and we should be aware of that. So I am hoping that we will get our communications up to date sooner than later, but right now Katla is behaving quite well as for earthquakes, and those smaller floods pose no threat to people or infrastructure, so don't let this video scare you, it's not meant for that. And if some tourists were waiting for a calm chapter to begin in order to visit this place, that the same tourists might have to wait for a long time. And as for history, Katla eruption start off with quite large earthquakes, and that is a good warning system for sure, and might even be enough. But I think it's time to think about whether we should send SMS warning to all travelers as they enter the area, just like we have been doing by Grindavík. And that SMS could include links to a page with further information, since we know for sure that not all guests know that this is not just one of our most popular tourist destination, this is just by one of our most dangerous volcano. So it was highly disappointing to find out that our systems could work better recently, since I've been saying all along that Katla is the best guarded volcano in Iceland. And I hope it will continue to be so after improvements. And I hope you enjoyed the videos from Katla. I was capturing most of them just a while ago. And I would like to go there again soon to do some more filming. This is such a landscape that we have there. Like actually by the whole south coast. And I could spend days just filming around the volcano alone. And might even do so when I find the time. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.